zoom in of this later, but I actually have a Finn the Human choker. It's really, really, really cute. Probably pretty aware of, it's pretty obvious. I'm a huge fan of bands and music. Before anybody accuses me of not listening to any bands that I show in this video, I promise you I listen to all of these bands and that I put on any shirt or clothing piece. And not only that, but I probably have played their songs on guitar, so that just took it to a whole new level. If you haven't subscribed yet, what are you doing? Be sure to subscribe. I'm gonna play like a cool guitar solo or something here just to go with the whole theme, because I'm feeling it. Tumblr inspired and grunge. So if you love that, you're in for a ride. So let's see if we can get this to 3,000 likes in one night. Stop the video, go play one of your favorite songs, and like it now, and replay. If this gets to 3,000 likes in one night, a DIY room decor band edition, oh yeah, that could be epic. Clothes inspired by band members, like 5 Seconds of Summer or Alex Turner or something. Leads me to the comment challenge. I want to hear from you guys, so give me band recommendations, music recommendations that could be well-known, not well-known. Happy Earth Day, yay! Stay until the end to see how you could help out this Earth Day. Guitar riff, and I'll get into this. Okay, bye.
So I'm starting off by taking the classic band tee and taking it to a whole new level. So I'm starting off with a plain black t-shirt, and this looks the best on black and the most grunge. I'm actually just twirling random little knots, and I'm securing them with rubber bands. Trust me, it'll look awesome. And I put bleach into a spray bottle, and now I'm just spraying random little sections. This whole process can really be pretty messy and still look great. After I let it dry for a day, I printed out a band logo on photo transfer paper. I used paper for light fabric so that you'd be able to see the design through the logo, you'll see. And grunge skulls are necessary. I just found these iron-on ones from Joann's and just follow the instructions that they come with. I thought they looked awesome around the collar. I definitely recommend you do this, very grunge. I did the Arctic Monkeys, but you can really do any band. Even if you're not going to like a concert or something, you could still make this and it would still look awesome. It's calling me sassy. Beanies go perfectly with concert tees, just saying. Life hack. You can actually make these from sweaters. I hope you're enjoying the Arctic Monkeys instrumental. So now I took some iron-on letters. You could get these at any craft store, Amazon, eBay. And from personal experience, white always shows up the best. I cut around the shape of each letter individually. Spoiler alert, mine's gonna say band expert. So then you just lay them out where you want them to be on the beanie and you iron them on. This is incomplete without actually showing off your favorite bands, so I took a bunch of band buttons and put them on the beanie and you're done. This beanie's awesome because you can personalize it with all of your favorite bands and you can bond with people. People will see your beanie and be like, hey. So why just the band merchandise to being beanies and t-shirts? Just took a normal red, not grunge dress. This also looks cool with a black dress. It was a dress that I barely wore because it was just so simple. I'm like, I'm gonna do something cool. So I'm twisting it so that there's one big twist in the center. You can kind of see how I did it there. There are tons of tutorials online. And then I secured it with a rubber band. So now I'm taking bleach in the spray bottle again. And I'm just doing the same thing I did before, spraying in random places. The twirling it up and the actual bleaching don't have to be very neat, trust me.
Also, I should have said this before, but definitely wear gloves and do this outside.
Now for the fun part, take the band logos of all your favorite bands, make sure that all of them are pretty small, and print them onto photo transfer paper. So after I let my dress dry overnight, I am cutting out the band logos around the shape of them. So at the top of the dress, I am putting a ton of them all crowded around there and ironing them on. And all the leftover ones, if you have leftover, it looks awesome if you put them around the bottom of the skirt part. Also, I recommend using photo transfer paper for light fabrics because that way you can see the fabric. Doesn't have to be all frills and lace, it can also be bands. I think this dress is just awesome, and it's totally personalized because it's all your favorite bands. That is the best thing about doing DIY clothes.
Grunge sign. It was calling to me. Like, do you think it could be like Mario and just like
intensely introducing the final DIY. So I took a bunch of Tumblr transparents that were related to music and put them in front of grunge backgrounds. Yes, I searched up grunge backgrounds. And I took a bunch of small wood pieces. After printing out the designs, I cut them out and wrapped them around the wood pieces. If you need to, secure it in the back with glue. I actually didn't need to, just wrapping it around kept it into place. And the sizes and shapes of the wood pieces can vary, also like the designs can vary. My hours of stalking Tumblr trained me well for this. If you want, you don't even have to do this with music, but I'm going with the theme here. So now we're gonna be making these into buttons slash pins. I took pin backs, you can get these from craft stores, and super glue, and just super glued the back of the pin to the back of the button. And you can put these anywhere, you can put them on a backpack, a beanie, but my personal choice was a leather jacket. Sound cute. I had a bunch of mess ups and scraps and things like that, and I found out that H&M and DoSomething.org were doing something where you could donate clothes, and all the clothes got sent to a recycling facility. Not sponsored, I just think it's amazing that there are companies that work so hard to make it easy for us to donate, and this works perfectly because today's Earth Day, so look at that. By the way, this particular cause that I'm helping with is called Comeback Clothes, and it's running until May 31st, so you could still do it. And they gave me coupons. It was 15% off an entire order. I'll link the codes down below if you're interested, and that is it for this episode of Extreme Couponing.
Was this video not incredibly grunge and Tumblr and epic and... Those are like the only three words in my vocabulary. I'm pretty grunge right now and I'm feeling awesome, honestly. I hope that your inner punk rock really enjoyed this. If you haven't liked it yet, what are you doing? Do 3,000 likes in one night, especially if you guys want to see more stuff with this. If you're not a person that normally participates in the comment challenge, you're really missing out because it's a lot of fun because we're an accepting community here. So comment your music recommendations. It can be well-known, unknown, it could be songs, bands. Honestly, I have my headphones in like 90% of the time, so chances are while you're watching this, my headphones are in. I'm not exaggerating. I'm just gonna play some really epic guitar riffs and do some of my really bad dancing. Okay.